Hey guys, in this video you're gonna learn how to use Create Shape tool, Select Point tool, Line Width tool, and Delete Edge tool in Moho to draw an amazing watch. Also, lots of great tips to draw are waiting for you. Let's do it! Well, let's start. I'm gonna use Create Shape to create a rectangle. And then I hit the T key and set these two values to 0 to move our rectangle to the center. Then I'm gonna hold down the control and select these two points and go back to select point tool. Up here we have a split option. If we click on it, it's gonna put a new point between the selected points. I'm gonna do the same once again, and then I drag to select the lower points. Let's click on a split and again, and as you know, if I hold down the control I can draw to select the points. But what if I want to use the transform tool? In order to do the same, you have to enable the lasso mode, and then you can hit the T key to select the transform tool and hold down the control and draw like this. By holding down the control and shift, I can add to my selection. And now I'm gonna drag from the top, and also I'm gonna hold down the alt key. By holding down the control, I select all of these points and hit the C key and drag to the right to make them smooth. Then I'm gonna hit the Q, select the shape, and choose a dark color for it, like this one. Then I'm gonna hit the C key again. By holding down the control and click on somewhere, I can see the beziers. So now if I hold down the control again and drag, I can select these two points. And let's drag them to the left to make them more circular. After that we need a circle, so let's choose the circle to draw. It doesn't matter where you draw it, so I'm gonna drag and hold on the Alt to draw from the center, and I'm gonna hold on the Shift to make it a pure circle. Then it's time to hit the Q, choose the shape, and choose a gray color for it, like this one. Then I'm gonna hit the T key and set these two values to 0. Let's use Ctrl C and V to make a copy of it. I'm gonna drag it from here by holding down the Alt. I can scale it from the center. Let's actually make it a little bit bigger. After that you should use Q to select your shape and select its color. Let's hit the T key to select the transform tool. By holding down the control I'm gonna select these points like this, and by dragging from the top and holding down the Alt I'm gonna actually resize the shape because the size go in depth. When you have multiple shapes, in order to select your shape so quickly, you can create some groups. And I don't mean the groups that are here, but the groups that are related to the tools. So let's select the select point tool and select these points. I'm gonna hold down the control and shift to add to my selection. And type the name of your group. This is, for example, our watch. And remember, you have to click on create unless it's not gonna create your group. So let's hit create. Now it's time to hit the T key and move this out of the screen. Then you have to draw a line, so I'm gonna use add point tool to do this, like this. By holding down the shift you can draw horizontally. I'm gonna hit the T key, hold down the control and select these two, and make sure that this line is at the center of the screen. It's time to use Ctrl C and V to make a copy of it. Let's rotate it by 30 degrees. I'm gonna repeat this action multiple times. Ctrl C and V, 30. Again, Ctrl C and V. Ctrl C and V. Now it's time to hit the S key to draw a new circle. And remember, you have to hold down the Alt and Shift. After that you have to hit the T key and set these two values to 0 again. Let's make it a little bit bigger than this. By holding down the Alt I can make sure that I'm scaling from the center. And now let me introduce a new tool. We have a tool called Delete Edge, and if you select it you can delete the paths, and we're gonna delete all of the edges inside this circle. But you can actually delete this one because, you know, we don't have any point here or here to divide this line into two parts. So I'm gonna hit Ctrl Z and choose the select point tool, And by dragging, I'm gonna select all of these points and choose weld crossing. So it's gonna put a point where a line intersects the other one. And if I hit the T key to select the delete edge tool, now I can simply delete these edges like this. We don't need the circle either, so let's delete it like this. To convert these into a stroke, you can select the create shape tool or hit the U key. And here you can tell the software whether you want to create a fill or a stroke or even both. In this case, I'm going to create a stroke only. So I select this and then I choose create shape. Let's go back to select point tool. To create a group for this, we have to hold down the control and select all of the points and type here marks. And then I hit create to create my group. Now, if I click on here, I can select whatever I want. For example, I want to select watch. And by hitting the T key, I can move it back to its first position by setting the X value to 0. Then let's select the marks again. I'm gonna drag it from the corner. By holding down the Alt, I can do it from the center. And that's it. To check their positions, I have to hold down the control and click on somewhere. Let's call this layer body and add a layer on top of it called hands. And now it's time to draw some hands for this watch. Make sure you've selected this layer, and I'm gonna scroll up to zoom in and select the add point tool and drag. By holding down the shift, you can make sure that this line is vertical. And if I hit the U key, I can select the create shape tool. So let's select this edge by clicking on it. Make sure that this stroke is enabled and let's create shape. Moho also have another fantastic tool called line width. I'm gonna select it. And as you can see, the size of tool is so big. You can change it by dragging on the number like this, or by clicking on the number and type. Or the best way is to hold down the Alt and drag to the right and left. If you see this red circle in Moho, it means that it's gonna focus on the center of the circle, but it also has some effects on the points that are inside the circle. If you don't want this at all, you can disable it by removing this check, like this. But most of the times, I believe it's better to enable it, and let me change its size. If you drag to the right, you can increase the width of the line, and by dragging to the left, you can decrease it. I'm gonna hit the Ctrl Z twice. You can also hold down the control and drag like this to select the points that you want. And then you can change the width by typing like this. This value here is related to your main width, which can be found here. And if you look at here, you can see it's based on percent. So when it's 100, it means that the width of the selected point is 4. But right now, because we've changed it to 200, its width should be 8. I'm gonna hit Ctrl Z this time, and by scrolling up, I can zoom in a little bit. Let's hit the A key to select the Add Point tool and add a point somewhere around here. This time, if I go back to Line Width tool and hold down the Alt and drag to the left to make the circle smaller, you can see that it only recognizes the points and not the lines. So let me drag it to the right to make it a little thicker. I'm gonna hit the T key and hold down the control and press A to select all of the points. And let's move this anchor point to somewhere around the center and scale it from somewhere around here. I'm gonna hold down the Alt to scale it from the anchor point. It should be good here. Let's press Ctrl C and V to make a copy of it. Then I'm gonna move the anchor point to somewhere around here and rotate my new shape like this. It's time to scale it again. I'm holding down the Alt to do it from the anchor point. Maybe a little bit smaller than this, like here. Then you have to hit Q, select the hand, and set your width. 3.5 should be better, so yeah, like this. Let's hit the T key again, Ctrl C and V to make a copy of it. Move the anchor point to the center. and rotate our new hand. I'm gonna hold down the right click to pan, and by holding down the Alt you can scale it a little bit. Let's hit Q to select this shape and set our width like this. Now to reset your view, you can press home on your keyboard like this. Let's have a new layer. I'm gonna call it extra. It's time to draw a rectangle somewhere around here. Let's hit the T key and set this Y value to 0 and hit the Q, select the shape. I'm gonna choose a gray color for it, and it's better to change its scale. I'm holding down the Alt. Let's go back to body layer. This time I'm gonna take the head of the watch out of this layer and take it to a new layer. To do that, you can select these two circles by selecting one of them and holding down the Shift and select the other one. Then by holding down the Control and press X, you can cut these two circles. After that, you have to create a new layer. And by holding down the Control and press V, you can paste it into the new layer. We have to name it. Let me call this head. And now if you go back to the body layer, you can select the marks, hit Control X. And because this layer is selected, if I create a new layer, the new layer is gonna be on top of this one. But I want the marks on top of the head, not the body. So I select the head and create my new layer. Let's hit Control V and name this layer. It's time to work on the left side of the watch, so I'm gonna select the body. And then I hold my mouse somewhere around here and scroll up to zoom in. I hit the A key to select the Add Point tool and drag from here. I'm holding down the Shift to do it horizontally. I forgot to enable the sharp corners, but no problem, I can hit the C key and make it sharp. This time, let's select the Transform tool by hitting the T key and select these three points by holding down the Control. And I want to split them, so let's choose the Select Point tool and select the Split, and then hit the T key, hold down the Control and select these two points. I'm gonna scroll up to zoom in a little bit. And then because I want some curves here, I can hit the C key and click on here. If I hold down the Control and click on somewhere, you can see the new handles. Let's hit the T key and select these two points by holding down the Control. And then you can drag from the one side and hold down the Alt to do it from the other side simultaneously. It's time to hit the C key and drag to the right like this. And then I'm gonna reset the view by pressing the home key on the keyboard. And because I want a new layer on top of all of these layers, I can select the top layer and create my new layer like this. I'm gonna call it right side and click on the layer. Then I hold my mouse on here and zoom in by scrolling up. To begin, let's draw a rectangle from here to here. Hit the T key. Set its Y value to 0. It's better to scale it. I'm holding down the Alt to do it from the center. And this time I'm holding down the Shift to do it horizontally. Let's hit the S key. We need another rectangle. I'm gonna draw it. Then you should hit the T key and make sure that it's at the center. It's better to move it to the right. And then you should hit Ctrl C and V to make a copy of it and scale the new rectangle. I'm holding down the Alt to do it from the center. This time I'm holding down the Shift to do it horizontally. And now I'm gonna subtract this rectangle from this one. If you want to do it precisely, you can go to Select Point tool, hold down the Control and select all of these points, and select Weld Crossing. And then you should hit the D key to select the Delete Edge tool and drag to remove these lines. Also, we don't need these two. This time I'm gonna hit the T key, select these two, and move them to the left by holding down the Shift to do it horizontally. And then I'm gonna hold down the Control and select all of them. By holding down the Alt, I can change the scale of it from the center. And then let's use Shift to move it horizontally to somewhere around here. It doesn't have a fill, but we can add a fill to it using the Create Shape tool. by choosing fill and clicking on create shape. Let's hit the Q, select the shape, select the color for it, like this. Actually, you can change the color of this one too. It's time to add another rectangle in the middle. So I'm gonna choose a rectangle and draw. Then you should hit the T key and make sure that this value is 0. I'm gonna scroll up a little bit to zoom in and then hit the Q. And then as you can see, we have a problem with the width of these shapes. We can select all of them and set their width to something like 4. Let's go back to transform tool by hitting the T key. I'm holding down the control to select these 2 points and let's zoom again. And by holding down the Alt, you can change the scale from the center. It's time to zoom out and move these 2 points to the right. By holding down the Shift, you can move it horizontally. And to add depth to this design, we can zoom out using a scroll down and hold down the control and select these points. Drag from the top and bottom and hold down the Alt. I'm gonna hold down the control and select these 2 points and do the same. And now let's press the home key to reset the view. It's better to hold down the control and click on somewhere. Hold down the shift, and while the top layer is selected, you can hold down the shift and select the lowest layer. Release the shift, right click, choose group with selection, and name this layer, for example, watch. Let's choose right side layer. If you zoom in, maybe you want this shape behind the others. In that case, you can hit the Q, select this shape, and hit the down arrow key on your keyboard multiple times to move this shape behind the others. I'm gonna hit the home key again, and by holding down the control and press R, you can quickly render your project. Alright guys, that's it for this video, and see you in the next one.